Okay, cleaned up the cover, took our O-ring off, brushed her down, brake cleaned everything, Dremeled in the inside here, get any of the grit out, really gentle, any rust spots. And now we're going to put our new seal in. These pretty much line them up good. Should be able to just press them in with your hands because they are a little oily. So we're going to just do that and work our way around, make sure it's flush against the cover. Okay, she's pressed in. I said it's flush all the way around. Now if you go too far, you just got to go on the inside and push it back out. So you might have to readjust this again. We got to keep an eye on it. We're going to put it back together, but she's flush. She's good. Okay, since mine's a little stuck in there, I'm going to put a screwdriver in carefully on this and see if she'll pop out. So she's got a sleeve inside this. There's a nipple on here. Where there's a sleeve, we got a new one in our rebuild kit. So we're going to see if we can just get this pinion out for now. Alright, letting that sit with some oil. Can't get it out. Everybody else I've seen had a snap ring in here. I don't know if that's missing or I just don't have one, which is kind of weird. So anyway, take her for a C-clip to the top. On with your bar and brass ring. That's all gonna sit like that. Okay. This guy here, I'm gonna see if I can just put a socket. That's it for that. And she's out. Pretty nasty in there. So I'm gonna do the same thing with this, see if we can bang this bearing out like so and try to tap on this and push that bearing up off. Alright, same thing with this front cover to get that seal out. I didn't have a socket big enough, so I just made sure I supported it correctly in the bottom and got the very edge of it with a socket and tapped it and she popped right out and that's it. Alright, so we're gonna do this one here. Put a bearing over it and punch her out. She's going. That. And that's this piece here. So this one, obviously with the female side, came out of that. Okay. I don't think it makes a difference. I don't know. But either way, your tag or whatever, that's the side the female was in. And then your cover had the male in. I'll help get these bearings off a little easier. For whatever sake, I'm doing something else. I'm just soaking them. Some gas. So this thing's still jammed in there and I can't get it to pop loose. So very gently, I put two screwdrivers in. I'm hitting them, you know, back and forth, left, right, to get this pinion to pop out. And she's coming out little by little. You can see the sleeve in there. To the back left, that little white thing, that's your sleeve. It looks like it's coming out together, otherwise it's going to get jammed in there. And I've seen a couple guys mash them in, so it's something to grab onto and pull it out. So we're going to keep working back and forth with the screwdrivers and have her pop out. All right, gave up on that idea. So what I did is I just heated it up lightly around the bearing with a torch and I'm just kind of banging with my hammer. And she's coming out. And that's really it. She was in there pretty good, that's for sure. Damn, I wish I knew a couple women this fucking tight. Holy shit. That's that. All right. All right, like I said, since she's gonna be a pain, what I did is I collapsed her in on both sides. I'm just trying to break it as far as I can down without damaging that hole. And I'm gonna reach in there and just pull it out. Okay, now that you got that to hammered shit, I broke it down all the way to the bottom. I'm just gonna pull it out. All right, we're gonna take this bearing off this spline or whatever it is. I'm just gonna put it on some wood, and I'm gonna tap on it, get it to pop out. Like so, make sure it's just on the bearing though. And we're gonna tap it down. She's pretty nasty in there though, so if anything, I've had this in oil. We might have to heat it up a little bit and do it. We'll see. Okay, we heated that sucker up and she's coming off now. So that's it. I'm gonna keep hammering her out. And that's it. That's that one. I'll clean this up a little more and then reinstall the new ones in both the covers. Okay, putting this cover in. Seal. I just pressed it in by hand and we're just making sure it's level all the way around until it's flush. And that's really it. Okay, this one's all in, nice and flush. Okay. That's the way you want it. Now we're going to put the other one in here. Same way. Okay, same thing with this one. Nice and flush. Okay, we're going to work on these here, getting these bearings off. And we're going to do the same thing. I'm going to wedge in between the two pieces of wood and stick a socket on it or something and knock them out. Well, these are just going to lay right on and just try and tap on this, maybe with a block of wood on top. This one's a little weird. We'll have to figure out. I'm going to see if I have a piece of metal stock around here. I can stick that on the wood and on here with a socket and push down on the socket on that too. So, and for that we're just going to clean it up really good and stick the new one on. For whatever, I went through with a Dremel and cleaned out anything hard in there that was not clean to the touch, and around everything that kind of seals. And went in with some brake cleaner, cleaned it all out so it's nice and smooth, even in here, all nice and smooth. Like I said, we're gonna the big bearing here, which you got in your kit, goes on here, and then your other two one bearings go on these guys with smaller balls and multiple. I'm gonna clean up some of this rust with the Dremel here, and a little trick I seen online. We're gonna try it. We're gonna stick this piece in the freezer and leave our bearing room temperature or outside temperature, ambient, and help it slide on a little easier. So we're gonna try that. We're gonna clean this up, throw in a bag or something, and just stick it in the freezer. I was having a problem with these guys, so what I did is I cut most of the bearing off, outer rim, and then the ball bearings actually came out, and I just Dremeled it down. Didn't go too far, but just enough to give the metal room to expand, and part of the trailer fits perfect. Putting that on there, banging her, and she's coming right out. Like so. And she's out. Just pop the rest off. Bam. Pop the rest of it, she come right off. What is this I'm using here? 11/8 is what I'm using, but it don't really matter. So anything big enough to fit on there and you're good. So bearings are out finally. All right, I got one installed. So what I did is the other bearing, this is the inner part, you want to keep the other pieces of the other bearing if you can. I got the new one started. Okay. And just I got it centered on the lip, bearing to bearing lip, okay? And I got it started. And once I did,
it kind of just popped over, and because I cut slits in it, you know, it expanded and went down. I hammered her down, she's all the way in. So now we got a brand new bearing. So we're gonna do the same thing to this side here. I'm gonna flip it over so it's like this on the old bearing. I'm gonna hammer her down on in. Okay, so they're both on. Now I'm gonna go get my pinion gear I stuck in the freezer, and I'm gonna put the big bearing, the one with the bigger balls and less quantity of them, on the pinion bearing, and get that installed pretty much the same way. All right, for doing the pinion bearing I had in the freezer, what I did is I stuck the nipple of it in a 5/8 and put that down on a rock. So, and then I used the old bearing on top of it, like so, because my socket was not long enough on this impact, which was a 27 millimeter. Okay, so I did that, and I hammered her down. That's how she looks. So 5/8 on the bottom, and then the extra bearing and the 17 mil on top. And she is right in, nice and flush in there. And that's it.
Apparently in this kit we got two different the Titan washers, whatever you want to call them, that go on tip of this pinion that slides in. So I guess it's for different sizes, and luckily mine wasn't mashed up too much and I could just match it to which height I needed. So the small one's not going to work unless it goes to something else, but I don't think so. So we're going to use the large one, and what we're going to do is just stick it on this. There's all our clean stuff, new gaskets, seals, new seal. We're going to stick it on our pinion, and we're going to push her on in there, right on in. Okay, so got our spacer in there, lines up, starting to go in the hole, got it started. So what I'm going to do now is same thing. I'm going to put the bearing over it, and we're going to put our socket back on, and we're going to push her down until she's all seated in there. Okay, so once you get that bearing on there and the socket, and she's pushed all the way in, there we go. Careful you don't suck in this old socket back in there. So what I did is I went to a 7/16, and it fit pretty much right in the groove, little groove on the tip of that, and I just made sure she is fully in there, and that's it. Nice, gentle, smooth. Okay, so now that I've done, our seals are all in. I'm taking our new one here. I'm going to get that back on. Now be careful when you put this on. If anything, maybe a little bit of grease or something like that, just to get it past your new seal. And then if anything, just wipe off the excess when you're done. I'm going to press that through now. Like I said, I'm just taking a little bit of grease, and I'm just kind of coating the edge to help it slide over. Okay, that's all I want, just to make it easy. To go over that. Now this is the side of my wire, and it was my mail, so I'm putting it back the same way. I think someone said it didn't matter, depending on the wheel. Each side of the wheel, but this is the way I took it apart, the way I'm putting it together. I don't know. All right, so what I did is I put it outside on blocks, and then put my socket right on here and just hammered her down so she's nice and flush. Keep an eye on your seal when you do this. One side was going in a little high, so I just pushed on it gently on the rim closer to the metal. The tip of that with a screwdriver, just to give it a little more room for the metal to pop through, and then hammered more. So we're nice in. That one's done. So now we're going to put this stuff back together here. So I did notice that this little plastic thing, I'm going to need that. It did not come in my kit. Actually, it's metal. Really thin metal. So that's some kind of a washer, it looks like. I'm gonna have to look into that, but I think I need this to finish this job, so that's great. So another thing in that kit which I got, it's a complete rebuild kit. Well, on your plate here, your front cover with your wires, power your four-wheel drive. Since I'm going to order that piece, I'm going to see if I can order this piece and just swap it out. It looks like you're just going to, I don't know, stick a little hook in there and yank it out. So I can replace that, because now's the time to do it. And then also you can see up there in the top, 12 o'clock, somebody banged on this before. So my new seal went in a little weird, but it's sealed. So I'm going to push on a little bit with a screwdriver, but it's pretty much bent like that on the cover. So, oh, and I busted my wire. So we're going to have to, that's part of my magnetic, actually. That's what it is, engage the four-wheel drive. All right, so I'm going to need that, and I'm going to need to fix my wire. So that's what we're going to do. Order a new one of these, and that's going to make my magnet work to engage my four-wheel drive. So we're going to do that, and we're going to order this metal piece here. Another good reason to check your gentle with your parts when you're in your parts washer is, I didn't know what this was. Well, closer examination, even I cleaned this, it was right on there. So that's where it goes. So I'm guessing it goes on first, this little washer doodaddy, because it was still on there, unless it fell through. Well, yeah, obviously the only other two things are the plate snap ring and the retainer brass thing, whatever. So that's what it was. Alright, so update on this washer that goes on here. Couldn't find one. The hardware stores, looked online all last night. Couldn't find that piece separate, so I don't know. Anyway, what I came up with was this piece, lock and washer. I got it Lowell's. Now, it's a little bit thicker, but not much. But when it flattens down, it's pretty much going to be the same thickness. So we're going to try this and put this on because it does fit. Okay. That's that. Well, there's your part number from Lowell's. Alright, so now, update on this magnetic coil wire that I busted pretty much at the end of the whole job. Looked for that online. Apparently for this model on the 05-800 Sportsmans, they don't make separate. You gotta buy the whole cover. Not hearing that. I did find a couple other ones for scramblers and stuff. It's slightly different year that they sold separately. I don't know if they're interchangeable. So for right now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and get this out. Wasn't too much videos on this stuff. So what I'm doing is I just stuck a couple picks in here. Really gentle. And I got it to pry up. So that's where I'm at this very moment. We're just going to pry her up and see if I can get her out completely. And see what it looks like with this wire. So, there she is there, coming out. I try to go straight down to the bottom, so I didn't mess with anything on top. I'm going to try and do this with both hands. I'm going to put the phone down, but and my wire is on that side. I'm going to pull that part last. So I'm going to try and take this out and see if I can repair the wire and solder it back together. Okay, final update. This thing is just falling apart, okay? There's a rubber cover. Looks like there's plumber's tape that goes around it. And then there's a rubber seal that kind of goes in. And it covers the bottom of it and the top of the wires. And it's just, I'm stuck at the wire part right now. That's what she's stuck in. I haven't quite got there yet, but she's done. I'm just going to clean it out. All this little stuff now. I got to clean all this junk out. It's kind of sticking in spots. And we're going to have to work on getting the new one. So right now I'm going to have no four-wheel drive because this ain't going to work. So I'm just going to try and get this out. Clean it up and should be fine the way it is. The bearings on the inside of this piece. You can see. So. Whatever. We'll see if one of those scrambler ones or whatever it said will fit and match up to the size now that I smashed it. So I guess you can order one. It was like $50. I seen one for. And we can see if that fits in there. Otherwise, at the moment, I'm stuck buying a whole new front cover. So we'll see. Well, there's our wires. There's the gray soldered into one strand. And there's our orange going in behind that plumber's tape. And there she is at the bottom. That's probably why they say it's a non-serviceable item. It's got that little divot in there. That little grommet, whatever, that's sealing in the wires. Doesn't look that much of a pain. Looks like you can just push that little grommet out from in there. I know it's hard to see on the camera, but if you could just push that sucker out right there. Yeah, it's flexible too. I'm gonna push that right out and put a new one in. I'll see what the problem is. We're gonna order one of them other ones and see if it fits after I do a little more research on this number off the tranny differential casing and run it and see, because it was scrambler, it was for something else, I don't even remember, but different years, so we're gonna see. All right, she's all cleaned out down in there. I cut the wires really, really tight, so that's what it looks like. She's totally gone. Plastic all came apart on this thing, so whatever. All right, so what we're gonna do now is take our big old gear, throw that in, and we're going to load up our new cage, or prog, whatever you call this thing. Put our bearings in, and rollers in, and we're going to slip her down in there so, a little better. So the rollers are in here, are going to line up with the grooves. Okay, and from there, we'll get back. So what we're going to do is, I'm going to hold it about here, and I'm going to start putting them in the bottom row, and then I can drop it down. And then I'll start doing the top row and drop her down completely. Like so. Just lifting her up a little bit, enough to get them in there. You can see the spring. So. And once you've got, 2, 4, 6, 7. It's 14 total. Once you got all 7 on there, I'm going to push her down. Okay. And we're going to do the same thing with the tops. And just work our way around with these guys. And that's pretty much it. Follow suit. Okay, once you get them all in, she just goes right down. That's it. Now, we got to clean these up again because we didn't get new ones. When you put this in, try and put your teeth in where it's not on the actual rollers, if you can. There we go. Well, I guess it does sit on the rollers on this one. All right. The other ones don't. The other ones try and go offset, or otherwise it would be there off the rollers. So this one's going back on. All right. All right, so that little washer there, I just slapped down in there, because I'm going to put this together in one piece. So right now we're going to put in our armature plate, our O-ring in, and then I got to get this C-clip in, and that's going to do off camera with two hands. Just kind of hold it down and just work your way around until it snaps in the groove in there. Okay, get that pressed in, and now she's locked in. Okay, now this we're going to move, obviously, to get these tangs to line up in this cage, goes in the one with the rollers. Okay, we got our metal doodaddy. This pretty much goes in the center on here. You centered it with the tab to the back. So around there, and this little hole with roller whatever that is to sit in the seat, which is for your adjustment. We're gonna get that in there. So that's pretty much gonna line up to there to there. Okay, now without this bearing falling out, I'm gonna try and stick my finger in the axle part and hold it and swing around my armature bar as much as I can to get it into that cage, and at the same time getting this pin into my washer. And so all I did was just lift her up barely so I could see my armature bolt fit into my, do this with the damn phone, into my cage. Now it's kind of tucked up in there, but you can see it if you get a light, and then make sure that guy's lined up as well. And she just went right down, and she's seated, and that's everything. I'm going to bolt it back up, and I'm going to torque her to specs. Okay, once you do this, and put the screws in, I'm looking up the torque pounds now. This is your backlash. It said it's red Loctite on it, heat up. It says turn it out, and then you turn it all the way in until it makes contact, and then I think it said back a half turn or something like that. Spin this, make sure it's spinning freely, which mine is, so I'm not going to mess with it, and I don't have any play in there. And repeat procedure again if it's touching, a little bit, like an eighth turn at a time, until it's not touching, you're free. So I'm going to leave mine the way it is, but there's a procedure for that itself on your backlash and your dowel. All right, she's done. We torqued her down. And then while I had her out, I went and in the back here, it's number 8 bit. We put in a tad over 5 ounces, what you call for 5. So I just ran a little extra in there. Spinder, and she sounds great. So now we're going to install her and put everything back together.